So I think you're confused about something when it comes to the double slit experiment. It is because of the experiment. We were crafting an experiment such that we can make the interference pattern show up or break down whenever we want. But it's not because of the equipment. That's what the quantum eraser shows. Like, you turn on the detectors, and then the interference pattern breaks down, and that makes you think, well, the equipment, the detectors, are doing that. But then, if you add an apparatus later in the line that scrambles that data, then the interference pattern comes back, even if those detectors are on. So it passes through those detectors just like it did before, but those detectors are obviously not causing it to break down. Because you can get the interference pattern back with those detectors on. And it has nothing to do with human observation, because we don't need to observe it for this effect to take place. We can completely hide the data that the detectors detect and never have anyone see it. We could have it deleted as soon as it's recorded, and this effect still happens. So again, it does not hinge on human observation, and it does not hinge on the equipment. What it hinges on are the situations we put these quantum phenomena in. If we put it in a situation where it has to travel down one path or another, then it will act as if it traveled down one path or another, because that's the only thing it can do. But if we don't, if we instead put it in a position where it can and has to travel through both paths, then it will travel through both paths in a superposition. We are just making it fit to a mold, that's all. It's just a very weird mold, because one type of mold has it being in two places at the same time because of superposition, and the other mold has it being in only one place at one time. But that's all we're doing. We're just crafting scenarios in which a quantum state, like a photon, can only act in certain ways. We are creating situations in which it either has to be in a superposition or has to not be in a superposition. That's all. The experiment is causing it. It's just the equipment isn't causing it, and our observation isn't causing it. But the experiment, the scenario in which a particle can only behave in this way, is. It's not someone perceiving it, it's entanglement. And all that entanglement means is something is dependent on that particle's behavior. The detector is just that something that is dependent, but it doesn't have to be a person. And when there's nothing dependent on that particle's behavior, then that particle doesn't have to choose between quantum states, so it stays in a superposition.